Okay, so today we start a new subject, section 14 from the book, The Order Topology. Okay, so what is this? Well, we start with a simple ordered set. Let X be a simply ordered set with order. Okay, this. What do we mean by simply ordered set? Any two elements can be comparable. So, in other words, if x, y are in x, then we have either x is less than y is less than x, or they are equal. Okay. We know, of course, many examples, real numbers, integers, and so on, right? They are all simple ordered sets. Using this order, we may define a topology on that. But first, let's actually recall what we mean by an interval. So let's first define intervals. So we have, for example, an interval of this type. So this is just the set of x's such that x in x, of course, such that x is between a and b. This is the open interval, called open, but so far it has nothing to do with the being open in a topology, because we don't have a topology yet on X. We just use our experience from real numbers. That's why we call it an open interval. And this is by definition is the set. And finally, we have closed interval. Okay. So this is open interval, right? This is half open. This is the other kind of half open interval. And this is closed interval. Okay. All right. Now let's see the definition of order topology. To define the order topology, we will describe a basis. Okay, bases are very convenient ways of describing a topology on a set. Okay, let X be a set with simple order. Order. Okay. Assume that X has at least 2 points. So it shouldn't be empty, or it shouldn't have it shouldn't consist of a single point. It should have at least 2 points. Let B be the collection Okay, collection of all sets of the following types, daha doğrusu bir çeşit değil. Bir tanesi şey, all open intervals. AB in X. Second, all intervals of the form A comma B zero, where B zero is the largest element. If there is such an element of X, okay. And third type of sets we will consider all intervals of the form. This time A zero comma B, where A zero is the smallest element. Again, if there is any such element, okay. Well, then we claim that B is a basis for a topology on X. Okay. Of course, I mean, if there is no largest element of then we don't have intervals in the collection B of this type. Okay, A comma B zero. And again, if there is no smallest element, then we don't have again have this type of intervals in the collection B. In that case, so if we don't have largest and smallest elements, all we have are just open intervals, okay, in the collection. So it's like real numbers, okay. Real numbers, of course, has no smallest and largest element. Therefore, the standard topology there is just generated by open intervals. But if we have smallest and or largest element, then we have to consider this kind of intervals also. Okay, now I will not do the whole proof, but consider some part of it. Proof is not difficult, but contains several cases you will see in a minute. Well, we have to prove show two things as usual. First, what every element of the set X should lie inside one of this kind of right sets. But even you will see that this is not very obvious. All right, let's take any element. Now I must show you that this point should lies inside an interval of one of these kinds, either in this kind of interval or this kind of interval, and so on. You see, if there is an element, for example, okay, so if okay, let me write it this way. K is one, X might be the X is the X equals B0, the largest element. Okay. If this is the case, then the interval containing X is the following. We know that X has at least two elements. Therefore, it has an element other than itself, right? This X has an element other than B0. And since B0 is the largest element, that element is necessarily smaller than B0. Since okay, let me write. Since X has at least two elements, there is some y in X, and y is necessarily less than b0, which is x. Since b0 is the largest element, then x is inside this interval, right? Y is an element less than b0. Therefore, this is a this is an interval we may consider inside our collection, right? And clearly, B0 is an element of this interval because x is equal to B0. So this is case one. Case one. The other case, x equals A0, the smallest element of X. I mean, if there is, of course, such an element, but this is possible. Therefore, we have to consider this case. Then, again, since X has at least two elements, there is some y in X with y larger than a0, which is x. Then again, x is inside this what? Interval. So in both cases, we have we are done. The third case, X is neither the largest element nor the smallest element. This means X is okay, neither the smallest nor the largest element. Well, then, of course, then there are elements, not necessarily the largest or smallest element of this ordered set, but since X is not the smallest element, there should be some element smaller than X. And since it is not the largest element, there should be some element in X which is larger than X. So there are elements Y and Z in X so that Y is less than, sorry, X is larger than Y and less than Z, right? Because X is not the smallest element, therefore there should be some smaller element. X is not the largest element, therefore there should be some element larger than X. But hence, in this case, we have what? X is in the interval, of course, y comma z. So in each case, I have found an element of the collection B which contains this element X. Okay. Therefore, we show that. So I should write it this way. Hence, every point of X is contained in some element of the collection B. Well, then we have to, of course, consider the other condition for being a for being a basis. What's that? If okay, let I and j be two elements of the collection B, and x a point in the intersection. So we have to do what? Must show there is a third element of beta. There is some k in B, another interval, right? These are intervals, maybe half open. You know, one of the three kinds of intervals listed here, right? One of them, both I and J, and X is a point in the intersection of these two. Now I have to find a third interval. There is some K in B, so that X is in K, and K lies inside I and J. As you might guess, you know, there are many cases you have to consider. I can be one of the three types of intervals listed above. J again can be one of the three types. So there are nine cases. Okay. And then these intervals, how they intersect, one of them, some can be like this, the other one can be like this, or one of them can be like this, the other one can be like this, and so on, right? There are many cases. One has to consider all these cases. I will not do this, okay? I will not do this. The rest is left as an exercise. Just, you know, work on this, and I am sure, I mean, you can list all the cases and work out each case separately. It's not difficult, but it is, you know, kind of long. Okay, so that's the order topology. So once this claim is proved, the topology generated. Evet. Evet, haklısın. 9'dan az olacak. Ama şeyler var. Hani o işte nasıl kesişiyorlar. Onlar da var ayrıca. Bazıları kolay olacak, bazıları biraz ben hatırlıyorum bunu bir kere tahtada yaptıydım. Bayağı uzun sürüyor. Yani çok fazla case var ama hani her birisi kolay. Tamam mı? Okay. The topology generated by B is called the order topology on X on the ordered set, X and with the order. Of course, if you choose a different order, then you will get a different topology. On a set X, you may have different topologies. All right, so we already know, of course, the order topology on R. If this is the usual order on R, the order topology on R with this order is just the topology with basis open intervals, and that's the standard topology. It's just the standard topology. Okay, so there is nothing new in this case. Let's see another example. Let's consider let X to be R cross R, and this be the dictionary order on X. What do we mean by dictionary order? You compare the pairs as if they are words. So if let's say x1 y1 x2 y2 are elements of R cross R, then we say then x1 y1 is less than x2 y2 if and only if iki kelimeyi nasıl karşılaştırırsınız? İlk önce ilk harflerine bakarsınız, değil mi? Hangisi büyükse, yani işte sonra geliyorsa onu şey yaparsınız. If and only if x1 is less than x2 or x1 is equal to x2 and y1 is less than y2. Yani ilk önce ilk harflere bakıyorsunuz. Eğer x2 büyükse, o zaman diyorsunuz ki bu ikili bundan büyüktür. Eğer bu ikisi eşitse, o zaman ikinci harflere bakıyorsunuz. Eğer y2 büyükse diyorsunuz ki bu bundan büyüktür. Peki burada mesela interval'lar nasıl şeyler? Burada da yine tabii R'nin en büyük elemanı olmadığı için R çarpı R'nin de en büyük veya en küçük elemanı yok. Note that X has no smallest or largest element. Okay. Peki şey nedir? Mesela şu interval'a bakalım. Mesela ne olsun? Eksi 1'e eksi 3 ile 2'ye eksi 1'e 5 olsun. Mesela bu interval nedir? So, I would like to write down all the elements between these two points. So, I want pairs which are larger than this and less than this. Well, the x coordinates of these two are the same first coordinates, so it should be something like this, minus 1, and then here I should have x, and that x should be between minus 3 and 5, right? Picturally, this is something like this. Okay. So here minus 1, let's say this is the point minus 1. And minus 3 is somewhere here. And 5 is somewhere here. So my interval is just this line segment where the endpoints are missing. Okay. So as a subset of R2, this open interval is just this. Okay. What about this one? Minus 1, minus 3. But here, let's say 2 comma 5. Okay. What is this? Well, this has several parts. Maybe it is easier to just show this on a picture. Okay, let me just draw. Sorry. All right. My one is here. And then 2 is here. Okay. Now we consider all the pairs larger than this one and less than this one. Okay, I should also mark, let's say, minus 3 and 5. So it is this point, 2,5 is this point. So what do I have? I have everything larger than this point. So I have this infinite line segment. Okay, goes till infinity. And then maybe I draw this by a different color. Okay, şöyle yapayım. Şurada şöyle yapayım. Okay. Alright. I have yok bu fazla ince oldu. Okay. I have this line segment here. It goes till infinity, okay. And then have these lines parallel to the y-axis, okay. And finally, I have this line segment, okay. So everything between all the lines between minus 1 and 2, okay, which are parallel to the y-axis, and these two half open lines, they form this interval, okay. All these points. For example, this point has x coordinate already larger than minus 1 and has and its x coordinate is less than 2. Therefore, this point is in between these two points. A point here has the x coordinate equal to this one, but its y coordinate is larger. Therefore, it's inside in this interval. And a point like this has x coordinate equal to this, but its y coordinate is less than 5. Okay, so all these points belong to this interval. It goes till minus infinity. You are right. Okay. Peki. Try to give another example. Okay. Ya da bilmiyorum. Bakayım şurada var mı? Şunu yaparsak mesela let x to be let's say 0 1 with its usual order then of course x has the largest element, right? Largest element. So what are the intervals beta has, then B has the following types of intervals. Nedir onlar? Bir tanesi A, B şeklinde interval'lar. A ile B her ikisi de 0 ile 1 arasında, değil mi? Şöyle şeyler olabilir. A virgül 1 şeklinde interval'lar. A birden küçük, sıfırdan büyük. Sıfır da olabilir tabii. Açık interval alıyorum. Üçüncü çeşit yok. Right? Because x has no smallest element. So in this case my basis has two kinds of intervals. This interval and this interval. This kind of intervals. And actually again this is nothing but the standard topology on the interval X, right? This is nothing different than the usual topology. Okay. All right. So another topic, let's say 15, section 15, the product topology. Topology on X cross Y. Later we will consider more general products, but first this is a warm-up case. We consider product of two spaces. Here, so let X and Y be topological spaces. So both of them are topological spaces. With topologies, let's say tau and tau prime. Okay, let me write this way. Say with topologies tau x and tau y. But usually we will not, mention these topologies. But we will keep in mind that X and Y has, certain topologies. Okay. Now we will consider a basis for a topology on X cross Y. Let B be the collection of all sets U cross V of X cross Y, where U is where U and V are open in X and Y respectively. In other words, U is an element of tau x and v is an element of tau y. Okay. Then B is a basis for a topology on x. So claim is B is a topology is a sorry basis for a topology on x cross y. Okay, and the topology generated by B is called the product topology. Okay. On X cross Y, of course, one can define, several different topologies. If we say the product topology, we mean exactly this, whose basis consists of products of open sets of X and Y. Okay. Well, let's see the proof of this, which is again easy. So first, we have to prove that this collection covers X. In other words, every element of the product lies inside one element of B. Well, X comma Y is in this product. Then we are done because X is open in X. Y is open in X, then where? Okay. Since X is in tau X and Y is in tau Y, so X cross Y is an element of the basis, right? And we are done. Her elemanı içeren bir şey bulmamız lazım, baz elemanı. Herhangi bir x, y aldığımızda bu x, x'in içinde open, y de y'nin içinde open olduğuna göre x çarpı y zaten bu bazın bir elemanı. Ve tabii ki x, y'yi içeriyor. O halde bu noktayı içeren bir eleman bulduk. Peki, ikincisi ne olacak? Şöyle, iki tane baz elemanı alalım. Let u1, v1 and u2, v2 be elements of yok, böyle yazmayacağım. I write is a product. The elements of B, so that U1 and U2 are open in X, V1 and V2 are open in Y. And let X comma Y is in the intersection. Sorry. Intersection of these two basis elements. Well, this means what? So X is in U1 and U2, then X is in U1 and U2 because X belongs to here, therefore X is in U1 and X, Y belongs to here, therefore X belongs to U2. So X, X belongs to this intersection and Y belongs to this intersection. However, I am done at this point. U1 and U2 are open in X, therefore their intersection is open in X. V1 and V2 are open in Y, therefore their intersection is open in Y. Hence, X, Y is in the product of these intersections. Okay. Clearly, U1 intersection U2 is open in X, and V1 intersection V2 is open in Y, so that U1 intersection U2 cross product V1 intersection V2 is an element of this collection B. Finally, since X, Y belongs to this product, right? X is in the intersection of U1 and U2, and Y is in the intersection of E1 and V2. Therefore, we have found one element of beta that contains X, Y. Therefore, we are done. Okay. So, B is a basis for a topology. Okay. Sorusu olan var mı arkadaşlar buraya kadar? Okay. There is another way of describing a basis for the product topology. Let me also write down. Okay, if B is a basis for X and C is a basis for Y, then collection B. What is this? So B cross C's. B is in B and C is in C. Okay. All right. Then this collection is a basis for the product topology. On X cross Y. Okay, how can we do this? Well, evet. Nasıl? Ha, anladım. Ama o bariz değil mi? Şeyden. Evet, ama söylemem lazım. Haklısın. Since we have bu and şunu söylememiz lazım. Haklısın. U1 intersection U2 cross V1 in intersection V2 is inside what? This is inside U1 cross V1. Why is that? Because this subset is inside this, and this subset is inside this, right? So this tamam, bunu da yapacağım. Bunun şimdi bu çarpım, this product is inside this and Similarly, U1 intersection U2 is inside U2, and V1 intersection V2 is inside V2, right? Therefore, this product lies inside this intersection. So B3 is inside B1 and B2. And hence, we are done. Yani bariz diye düşünüp ihmal ettim. Anlaşıldı mı şimdi? Ya bariz ama söylemek lazım, orada haklısın. Da bazen işte hani böyle çok bariz gelince insan zihninde onu ihmal ediyor ama aslında söylemek lazım. Şimdi bu örneğe bakalım, bu teoreme. Burada da ne diyoruz? Elimizde bir topolojik uzay var. Ben bir başka koleksiyonun bunun bazı olduğunu söylemek istiyorum. Onu yapmanın yolu neydi? Değişik yolları vardı. Bir tanesi şeydi. Buradaki elemanların her birinin open olduğunu söyleyeceğim. Ve her elemanı, daha doğrusu her open setin içinde buradan bir tane eleman olduğunu söylemem lazım, değil mi? Öyle bir şey yapmıştık. Hani verilen bir koleksiyonun bir topolojinin bazı olması için şart vardı. Neydi o? Bir kere o koleksiyondaki elemanlar open olacak. Artı her elemanı içeren bir şey olacak. Yok, aslında şuradan bulmaya çalışayım. Evet, X bir topolojik uzay olsun. Bir tane collection alıyoruz. Open setlerden oluşuyor. Eğer herhangi bir open set ve onun içindeki bir nokta için koleksiyonda bir eleman bulabilirsem ki o noktayı içersin ve open setin içinde kalsın, o zaman bu koleksiyon da o topolojik uzay için bir baz olur. Bunu kullanacağız şimdi. Okey. O halde ne yapmam lazım? İlk önce bu elemanların her birisi open. Onu söylemem lazım. Since each B in B and C in C are open because these are bases of X and Y are open in X and Y respectively cross C is open in the product topology. Because product topology has bases consisting of products of open sets. Product topology X cross Y. Well, to show that this is a basis, we have to prove the following. W is a subset of X cross Y be an open set in X cross Y and X comma Y a point in W. Ne yapmam lazım? Ne yapmam lazım? Bir tane bu D koleksiyonundan bir şey bulmam lazım. Öyle ki bu noktayı içerecek ve W'nun içinde kalacak. Must find Bu arada zamanı geçirmişim. İsterseniz burada ara verelim. Aradan sonra bunu bitireyim. Çünkü bir 3-5 dakika alacak. Şöyle yapayım. Pardon.